I live in Canada. I've been there for a few years, but I was actually an immigrant arriving in Canada, originally from the Democratic Republic of Congo. I was blessed to be born in a family with a dad who was a diplomat, and so he's been an ambassador for my country. And so I was really introduced to this big vision of the world. My dad had a job at the United Nations back then. So life was, you know, life was amazing, changing countries. We lived maybe in 12, 13 different countries. I spoke many languages growing up. I still speak 5 languages. I just had this international view of the world. So that was one side of, you know, one aspect of my life, which was amazing. But at the same time, you know, it was also mixed with some sort of tragedy, you know, with my country changing governments and having a revolution. So that put our family in a very, you know, bad situation. I mean, in terms of, you know, we had to survive. We had to go to, you know, to survival, really. So life became tough, you know, in terms of we needed to find ways, you know, to, you know, make a living. My parents couldn't afford anymore. Everything that we grew up with, you know, was kind of, you know, disappeared overnight. We became refugees of, you know, of the world, you know, just trying to find, you know, a place, a country that could allow us to stay and all that. So this is where my Canadian history, you know, sort of comes along, where, you know, I arrived there in that country, you know, hoping to get started again. And I get there, and so I had to, you know, try to get established, try to get accepted by immigration. So I had a chance to become a landed immigrant, and then try to, you know, get myself going. I lived on welfare, so I know what it is to live on welfare. I still remember getting, you know, $500 welfare checks and having $400 of rent to pay, you know. That's pretty much, you know, how, you know, the type of lifestyle I had. So I go from there to, you know, finally, you know, being established and getting my papers. And now with that, you know, I can become a regular citizen. Finish my university, started working. So I kind of did the corporate thing. I used to work for a phone company in Canada, like one of, you know, the biggest phone companies out there. So the only way for me to escape that world was to use my other skills, which I'm also an artist in the music industry. So I was escaping with music. So I kind of, you know, escaped the job world. But when we had, you know, like gigs and concerts or tours, that's when life became amazing because I could just escape from that. But again, you know, after even taking a leave of absence for maybe 6 months to go on tour, but I always had to go back to get to the job, and it really became really depressing. I wasn't the type of employee that was, you know, happy to go to work. Every time the alarm clock rang in the morning, I was really, really not in a good mood at all, you know. And that's when, a year and a half later, okay, I came across now FHTM. It's always even better than my own vision.